Over the past years that I've served as both mayor and councilman and planning and zoning, I've seen the city grow to where it is today, to where I guess we're close to almost 80,000 people. So, you know, most of that change has taken place probably in the last 15 years, where we didn't used to be the industrial city that we are today, or the commercial city that we are today.
These are great times for growth, renewal, and innovation for the city of Missouri City. Innovation across all of our service areas remains a trademark, and the Show Me City continues to achieve milestones that makes us one of America's best places to live, work, play, and visit.
City's program has been successful because it has focused on the location, the proximity of the city's infrastructure to Beltway 8 and 90A. We've seen tremendous development in industrial, commercial, and warehouse space. We've benefited from the WCID number 2, which has available water and access to resources. We've benefited from an aggressive city council that has promoted a pro-business, pro-growth attitude in the community. And then we've seen tremendous growth in the residential communities from partners with Johnson Development. We've seen the development of Riverstone and the expanding growth of Siena. Siena has over 7,000 households on its way to 15,000. So that has really seen the development of Highway 6 with the investment of infrastructure from TxDOT. It's just been a tremendously growing and successful community. From projects like Benny Keith to projects like Niagara, Southwest Electronics, you look at Warren Alloy, Bimbo Bakery, Rich Products, Rich Foods, all of those are examples of projects that the city, through its economic development efforts and leadership of the city council and the city manager, have been able to attract to our community. It's created millions of dollars in investment and has primed the pump, where not all the projects that now come here have received abatements. In the last year and a half, we've seen over 300,000 square feet of new FedEx warehouse distribution center open up. It doesn't have an investment of any tax abatement for the city. The city has developed long-term relationships with developers. When you look at Lakeview Business Park, the city leadership reached out, worked with Trammell Crow, who was breaking new ground. You hadn't seen a new industrial park in this area for some time. So the city was aggressive in the manner in which it worked with the development community and developed a relationship. With that relationship, it allowed a foundation that gave comfort for that investor to invest millions of dollars and go attract companies to come to our community. And now you see the fruits of that investment. We are a prime location, or have been and continue to be, a prime location for warehousing, distribution, manufacturing type of environments. Another success that I think that we can't understate enough is the opening of the new HCC campus right next to City Hall. When you look at the capital investment that HCC has made on Texas Parkway, that's the single greatest investment that Texas Parkway has observed in decades. When you look at the benefits, you look at both the qualitative and the quantitative. And the qualitative is certainly you can say how many dollars have been invested and what does the building look like, and you can see that. The quantitative is the feel and the enthusiasm that is created by a capital investment. And HCC has certainly, with their investment and our partnership with them and the county's partnership and Johnson Development to make this, it was a very complex project. To make that happen, I think is a tremendous thing for the city, because you look at it and now you see the city investing in the campus around City Hall. You see improvements going on there from infrastructure. You see the county revitalizing the library. So there's a significant amount of spin-off benefit that we're already observing from the investment of HCC. We just finalized an agreement with Phillips Edison at the Quail Valley Shopping Center at Cartwright Road and Texas Parkway. They're going to be investing nearly $1 million in updates to their facilities. So there's a lot to be excited about. You know, that isn't say we're where we want to be. It doesn't say that there isn't a lot left to do. It's to say that things are getting done, and both the public and the private sector are recognizing the opportunity and investing in the area. And so that all really started, I think, with the announcement and then the investment from HCC into the campus there. That's just a tremendous kickoff. The city has put a prime focus on the redevelopment of Texas Parkway and the Cart Road area as an initiative for the economic development plan. So we're not going to lose focus on this. We're going to continue to invest and build upon the success we're observing right now.
We call the Missouri City Center for Health, entrepreneurship and information technology. And we did that because in conversations with the mayor as well as with community members, we understood the proximity of Missouri City with the Texas Medical Center. We also wanted to make sure that we will offer programs and educational opportunities that were in high growth, high demand careers that will allow our students in that community to have access to the program without having to drive far. We're doing a lot of engagement with the schools, and I'm extremely, extremely happy to be working with Superintendent Dupree and Superintendent Bostic at Stafford Municipal. And there's a great level of synergy between the school districts, city with Mayor Owens, and the city council at Missouri City, and our city manager, Mr. Snipes. It's been a wonderful, wonderful synergy of the best of our public servants coming together for the betterment of our citizens, and we're very proud to be part of that. This one place where you have City Hall, the public library, and a community college, higher education, is a gathering space for the community members. And then, of course, the community center, the beautiful new community center that is available for the citizens of Missouri City. So you put together access to City Hall, a new city community center, a higher education presence with Houston Community College there, offering innovative and high growth, high demand programs, and the close partnership and engagement with the school districts. And, you know, it just speaks so loudly of the commitment of everybody. I'm just amazed to the response of the community, and all the leaders there are extremely committed. And I, again, commend Mayor Owen for being such a visionary and an engaging person who advocates for his city and the citizens of Missouri City. And it's a pleasure to work with him and everybody in the community.
We've got a great addition coming. It's a beautiful addition. We had only a small space to work with, so it caused us to have to go up higher instead of trying to spread out. There was nowhere to spread out. That was a blessing in disguise, because what we end up having is a three-level building. And so to make it both an educational facility and a tourist attraction, we put a third level observation deck so you can get a good panoramic view of the area. The community college is also important. They're not going to have a dedicated area in that library for the community college, but I'm sure that the college students will utilize it, and we're working with HCC to try to provide a collection that can be conducive to the needs of college students. So it's a great asset to the community, has been for a long time, and when it opens up sometimes in the latter part of 2018, it's going to be a welcome addition from an educational standpoint, and definitely for contributing to the revitalization of that corridor. You have this nice tall building that just kind of lights up at night, and you'll see it. And I think we'll also want to make sure that it's a place where the community will want to have functions and events. So it'll welcome them in that regard too.
I've been through major storms in this city. I've been through Ike. I've been through floods. And so I've witnessed firsthand what public administrators do and their role in the city. You know, I'm very proud of the fact that during this last storm, we were communicating with our people, with our employees. You know, we were sending notifications out almost hourly to citizens, because what I saw during Ike was that people knew what was going on in Houston. They knew what was going on in Galveston. They didn't know what was going on in Missouri City. They didn't know whether we had evacuations. They didn't know what the story was. So I worked very hard from Ike to now, Harvey, to make sure that our communication was local, that we were telling our people what was happening in Missouri City. You know, when I signed the declaration, the emergency declaration, I wanted them to know it. When I put the curfew in place, I wanted our citizens to know that that was in place to protect them, that they felt comfortable in leaving home, that we were going to take care of them. I had those same, you know, state troopers patrolling our streets to make sure that we're safe. So again, I feel like that's my responsibility as the mayor, the leader, to be there, and I was. I felt like it was important that if my people could be there, I could be there.
The top-notch efforts of our first responders and first-line staff continue to receive praise from City Council, citizens, and commercial partners. Our public safety crews rescued more than 1,300 residents, and staff coordinated the use of city facilities as a resource during the disaster.
Seeing our people, our staff, be there 24 hours a day, 12-hour shifts, some of our employees losing their own homes. But yeah, their dedication was taking care of the citizens of Missouri City. I couldn't be more proud of it. We had the cooperation of people like the county and their emergency operations center. But I guess the most rewarding thing that happened to me was the night that I got a call from Niagara and stating that they had committed $1 million to Missouri City towards the recovery efforts for Harvey. That's partnership. Yeah, that's dedication. Benny Keith was bringing food in trailers to the city center while we were housing some 60 state troopers and 17 or 18 National Guard soldiers who were patrolling our streets, doing some 1,300 high water rescues, trying to help the people that were in some 1,500 homes that were flooded. But our people were in that city center, feeding those people, having them sleep there, having them patrol our streets. That's partnership. We had food trucks coming to the city center and to the emergency operations center serving food. We had local restaurants bringing food. We had individuals bringing food. Our people came with their arms full of stuff going, "What can I do for you?" Not coming with their hands open going, "What can you do for me?" I saw us come together as a city and learn that we need to help each other. We had neighbors helping neighbors, and that's what's so important, I think. That's the partnership that I'm most proud of. It was all of those employees in this city that were there every day.
It's an honor on a day-by-day basis to serve side-by-side every day with 368 of the most committed public servants in this great country. And I'm honored to be their city manager because together we excel.
I don't take water lightly. Water is probably the most important thing that we have to address today is how we preserve our drinking water, where we're going to get it from, how we're going to pay for it.
The Regional Surface Water Treatment Plant is one of the crown jewels of the infrastructure projects located within Missouri City. This project was commissioned back in 2012 at a cost of approximately $50 million. This project was envisioned to provide potable water needs for this growing community. It was commissioned with strategic partnerships with about 30 other municipal utility districts in this region and a bunch of private entities as well. This project not only supplies potable water, but it's an environmentally stewardship type project. The intent is to reduce reliance on groundwater and use surface water for potable water needs, which is one of the mandates of the Fort Bend Subsidence District. Currently, we are meeting the demands of using 30% surface water. This project was conceived in a very fiscally responsible manner. We produce and supply water at a wholesale rate of about $2.12 per 1,000 gallons, which is one of the lowest cost in this region for wholesale water producers.
We pull water in from the river into reservoirs and treat it to be potable drinking water with a very high quality. We have a demand today of about 9.5 to 10 million gallons because of all the growth. We have an expansion coming up, which will start in June 2018. It'll bring this plant to a 20 million gallon a day plant. And within the next 3-4 years, we see our demand growing to about 13 to 14, 15 million gallons a day, somewhere in that area.
Through the hurricane, with 40 inches plus rain and high winds, we stayed in operation producing water 24 hours a day through the whole storm. We never lost pressure, which meant we would have had to do a boil water notice like some communities around us. The plant stayed up and running with emergency generators, and we stayed high and dry the whole time. And special thanks needs to go out to our operator, Quail Valley Utility District, who stayed here and manned this operation for 6 straight days.
I'm very proud of the fact that over these years, we've had a city council that gets along. It's diverse in itself. It's very representative of the city. And I'm very proud of the fact that we work together to do what's best for the city. We don't always agree. You never will. You know, if everybody just went along with everything that the mayor wanted to do or one council person do, we probably wouldn't get where we are today. We need to sit down and talk about the differences of opinions. as Rice University said, the most diverse city in the region. And I've said this before, there are 94 languages spoken in Fort Bend ISD School District. In our city, as diverse as we are, we've learned to live together, go to school together, go to church together, get along with each other. We are the city, the Show Me City, to live in.